How's it going, everyone? Monospider here, bringing you another episode in Board Game Arena. Today, I'm going to be looking at a new game called Can't Stop. This game is for 2 to 4 players, it takes about 9 or 10 minutes to finish, and it's relatively simple. Board Game Arena gives it a 2 out of 5. So, I'll jump in with our first game. Alright, everyone, so jumping into this game, Can't Stop, it's a really, really simple concept of the game. You roll 3 sets. Essentially, you roll 3 times with 4 dice, right? So you've got your 3 different sets of dice with 4 sets in each, with 4 dice in each set. Now, what happens is you get these combinations and you move up the respective tracks. So in my example, my first set of doubles I threw was a 7 and a 6. My second set of doubles I threw was a 4 and a 9. And my third set of doubles I threw was a 4 and a 9. Now, I can choose one of these sets and I put my marker up on those respective tables. So for example, I'm going to choose 4 and 9. Now you can see I take my markers and I push them up one track on 4 and 9. The objective of the game is to be the first player to top 3 of these pieces. Now I can choose to either continue to roll my dice or to stop. Now the trick is you've only got 3 markers to place each turn. So I need these 3 sets of dice. Out of them, I need to be able to place my last marker on one of these. Now, I've rolled 6, 5, 7, and 4. Now, I've already got a marker on 4, and I've already got a marker on 9. So this 4 and 7 works quite well, because 7 is the most common number you'll roll, hence why it's the most difficult to go up that track. So now I've got no markers left, which means that if I choose to roll these dice again, and I don't roll a 4, a 7, or a 9, I can't play, and I'll now lose the progression on these tracks. If I choose to stop my progression, then I replace these black tokens with my colored tokens. And then from there on my next turn, I can then progress again from these tracks or start a new one. So I think I can push my luck and roll again. In this example, I failed. And none of my 3 sets of dice rolled the 4, 7, or the 9, which means that I lost all of my progress. Which means I'm now essentially in last place, because I've got no progression. But it looks like the third player also happened to get rather unlucky and got nowhere. So currently, the only player on the board is our red player, who has made 2 progressions on 5, 2 progressions on 6, and a single progression on 10. So in this game, you've got to know how far to push your luck. Sometimes you get super lucky and you can progress an entire track in a single turn. Other times, you look like you're getting a bit far, and then unfortunately the dice betray you. I've had those times where all of my dice have literally rolled 4s. So you gotta see how far you can push your luck. Sometimes you get lucky, sometimes you don't. As you can see, our red player here has actually progressed quite nicely as we've got a really decent spread across. So now on my second turn, I've rolled 6, 4, 3, 7, and 5, 5. Now I quite like the idea of double progressing on 5 because this leaves me still 2 more tokens for my next roll. So I'm going to roll again, and I see I got myself a 9 and a 12. Now, I'm actually going to stop on this one. And the reason for that is, it's relatively difficult to stop, to progress yourself on 12 and on 2. So as soon as I can get a 12, I normally stop on that. I don't push my luck too much further, unless I've still got tokens in the bank. So now, as you can see, because I stopped, I've taken my green tokens and I've put them on however far I progressed with my previous roll, which was 2 on 5, 1 on 9, and 1 on 12. Now on my next turn, I'll then be able to start again. So if I were to roll another 12, my black marker would start on the second 12 slot rather than on the 0 one again. So you're essentially continuing from wherever you placed your markers previously. Our red player is getting really, really lucky and they're progressing quite far along on 5. Now, what makes this game challenging is the mid to end game. Once the player essentially tops out on one of these peaks, that number is closed and you can no longer roll it. So for example, when this red player tops out on 5, the entire 5 row will be closed and then no one can place a marker on 5. So as much as I want to progress on 10, I really don't want to progress on 5 because there's a very high chance of that being closed soon. So I'm rather going to choose to progress on 7 and 8. Whilst these aren't great options, it's a bit better than the other option. So let's roll again. You see, now we've got 6, 8, 5, 9, 5, or 9. Now I could progress on 6 and 8, which is looking all right. 5 is basically dead in the water. And 9. 9 is looking pretty good. So let me go for 9 and see how we do. I'm feeling lucky. Let's roll again. I can progress on 7 and 8. Now, unfortunately, I do need to catch my opponent, so I need to push my luck a little bit further. Let's see what we get. As I'll push a little bit further, so I can push my 9 up that much. I think I'll try it one more time. I feel relatively confident because I've got a number on 7, which is quite good. That roll spooked me a bit, so I think I'm going to stop there and just save my progression and continue from there. Overall, this game is a lot of fun because it's very casual and it's a nice game to start off your session or close your session because it doesn't require that much strategic thinking. This game is a dice game, which is intrinsically luck-based. The difficulty of this game is knowing how far to push your luck. Sometimes if you're feeling lucky, as I said, you can clear an entire row in a single turn. That rarely happens. It generally ends up being a slow grind to get to the top. That blue player got really, really lucky this turn on 6 and has progressed very well. So it does look like I'm actually in last place, which is unfortunate. But let's see how this game progresses. As I said, sometimes you get lucky and sometimes you don't. This game really is casual, it's a lot of fun, and it usually takes about 10 minutes or so. So it's a nice game to just sit down and get comfortable with the players around your table. Now, as for what I want to do next, I really want to progress on 12, so seeing my opponent get 2 on 12 is really scary. And I didn't get a single 12 again, which is worrying. So what do I have? Do I have anything on 10? 10 is basically free game, and 8 is not bad. So I'm happy taking both of these. I rolled all of my dice rolls were the same, which is a bit unfortunate. So don't exactly have an option. So let's keep on rolling. What do we get? 11 is basically free, otherwise we can do 10 and 8 again. I like doing 10 and 8 again because that leaves my last token still free, which means I can still play around quite a bit. 5 and 8 I don't want. I want the 8, I don't want the 5. 6 is basically dead in the water, 7 isn't much better, and 6 and 7 doesn't help me, so I do think the 5 and 8 is the best track to progress here. Let's see, do I get lucky? Okay, I do get lucky. I can either get 10 or I can get 8. I think 10 makes more sense because it is a bit harder to progress. Let's do it one more time. Ah, I pushed my luck too far. Ah, that was unfortunate. I got a bit too greedy there. I tend to not do so well at this game because I tend to get very, very greedy and I end up burning myself quite badly. which is quite interesting. So this game's a lot of fun if you want to see how far you can push your luck. It is a very casual game. I tend to prefer the more core games, more the more intense games, but I like these games for a good laugh and just to see how your luck is going for the day. I do think I'm playing a little bit too aggressively, but at the same time now I'm playing so far behind that I have to play aggressively, which is kind of like a vicious cycle. So generally in the early stage of this game, you kind of want to spread your tokens across the board and go for a bit more of a slow grow. I made the mistakes of trying to push really, really hard, which hasn't come in handy at all. 4 is open, 5 is dead. 3 is an option. Maybe, let's see. Let me go for 4 rather. I think 5 and 4, even though 5 might close very soon, I think that's better off. Okay, I got a progression on 12. Now, do I want to push my luck and finish 12 or just wait here? I don't want to lose my track on 12, but at the same time, I really want to finish it. Let's try one more time, if I can push my luck. Okay, I got to push my luck a little bit further. So let's push that 4. I think, let me stop there. I really want to close this 12. I'm scared red is going to close it, but I need to get at least one line done. So as I said, the way to win this game is to have 3 of these lines done. I'm not too concerned with blue, because I don't think blue will be able to close it. Blue is probably going to close 3 very soon, which is scary. Okay, red didn't get 12, that's good so far. I really need to get 12 on my next roll to close it. And then we can see what it looks like when you've actually got a line closed. Ah, my opponent's closed 2. That's worrying. Okay, so as we can see now, this line is now being closed. And I've been able to close my one as well, which is quite good. let's roll. I'll roll one more time just to progress a little bit further. And let's progress on... I guess I can double tap 7. Because 6 is dead in the water. Everything else is basically dead in the water. I'm going to stop here. Because now I've essentially closed 12. Which is really good. So essentially now I have 1 VP and our red player has 1 VP. Because we've both closed one of the lines. One of the peaks. So a third of the way to victory. My problem comes in that the rest of my pieces are really low down on the board. I need somehow catch up. Now the problem is blue's now closed 2. So it has now closed 3. So now we roll on 1 VP and now 3 of our set of numbers is now closed. Which means it's that much more difficult to get your rolls out consistently. Because essentially if you roll 2, 3 or 12, you can't progress on those lines. So those combos are now dead. And now 5 has just been closed. So red is doing really, really well. And they're about to close 8 as well. So I don't know how much longer this game is going to go on for. So let's progress on... So see here, I rolled a 12, which means I can't progress there, which is why I only have this one option. So let's progress on 9 and 10 and see what happens. I'm really scared because basically, so long as my opponent rolls an 8, it's going to be game over. So let's progress on... Oh, we should progress 9 and 8. Well, 11 is looking pretty decent. 6 is looking dead. Let's do 9 and 8. I really want to try and push this 9 as much as possible. Let's try one more time. Let's progress 8. I'd have to get so far on 8. It's not even funny. Let's progress on 8 again. Let's progress on 8 again. Can I do this? No. Okay. I was really hoping to push all the way through on 8. But I mean, you can only push your luck so far. The reason I really went all in there was because I know red is really close to finishing this game. I kind of have to go for the crazy plays to try and finish. And it certainly wasn't a good play. So let's see what happens next. Maybe I should have played it a bit safer there. You'll see blue is about to finish 7. Yeah, they're probably going to finish 7. Okay, they actually stopped. Okay, it looks like red doesn't have an 8 just yet. They got really bad rolls there. They only got 4s. And there's their 8. That's game. Well, that's unfortunate. But hey, it is sometimes you win and sometimes you lose. So as soon as my opponent clicks an 8, that should be game. If they get there. So this is a very brief description of Can't Stop. I will jump into another game to showcase a little bit more. Because it's quite a fun game to play. Unfortunately, there's only 4 players. It'd be quite nice if there were more players. But hey, it is quite interesting. And as I said, it's a fun game to kind of get into it. And there is the end of the game. So, Boat Shepherd, well done, my friend. You thrashed us. Alright, so you can see there that that Boat Shepherd did get an additional 10 points. So, I'll restart the video again when I've jumped into our next game. Alright, everyone, jumping into our second game of Can't Stop for this video. As on the previous one, I gave a brief description of how to play the game. And a quick summary, once again, is that you're running basically 3 sets of dice with two sets of dice in each of those sets. And then you progress on the tracks that correspond to the numbers you rolled. 6 and 11 looks quite good. I can rush my opponent to 11 and hopefully beat them. So we're going to try and play a little bit more carefully this game. And not go all in. Okay, there's a 12 and a 6. I am going to stop here. That was a very nice spread. I got 1 on 12, 2 on 11, and 3 on 6. I'm very happy with that. So this game, again, you're rolling these dice. You're progressing on the corresponding tracks. And you're trying to get your way to top out on one of them. The game, as you see from the game board, it takes the most amount of steps to move up 7. Because it's you're more likely to roll 7 on a die roll. And it's one easier in either direction. So for 2 and 12 respectively, you only need 3 slots each. Whereas for 7, you need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So it goes from just being 3 to 13. So there's a big difference between rolling on a 12 and rolling on a 7. Alright, so it's back to me. 6 and 8 I quite like because my 6 is progressing very, very well. Let's continue. What else do we get? So from here on, we get... You get a double 8, which is quite interesting. Or I can progress on 11, which I think might be a bit more useful. Again, I'm trying to push my luck one more time. There's 8 and 11. That's huge. Okay, I'm going to stop right here because now I only need one more for 11 and I can close 11 really, really early, which will be great. So this is looking quite good so far. Okay, not too bad. My opponent's still spreading quite well. They haven't got anything on the board yet, this blue player. So hopefully they can progress this turn. They're progressing really well this turn. My word. Gonna continue. Oh, I was going to say, they need to stop at some point. But that was a fantastic turn from our blue player. So it really does come down to how much you want to push your luck. Because you've only got three tokens. So you can only progress on three numbers, essentially. And once you've locked in those three numbers, if you don't roll one of those three numbers amongst your six sets, you don't progress. And you lose all your progress. Which can be really, really unfortunate. So 8 and 5 I don't really like. 10 and 3... 10 and 3 maybe is the best? I think 10 and 3 is the best. I don't want to bother with 7. I tend to not like rolling on 7. It's a bit much. I didn't get 11, which is unfortunate. I can progress on 9. Progress on 8. Let's progress on 8 a bit. Let's see, what do we get? Let's push up a 10 a bit higher. Let's try one more time. I got unlucky there. That was unfortunate. Okay, I thought I'd be able to get at least one more. But I probably should have stopped rolling. Okay, let's see. Blue's getting really lucky again. They keep rolling 5, 6, 7. My word, they're getting lucky. No way. Are they going to close? Okay. They are getting super, super lucky. That is terrifying, because they might be able to close 5 and 6, which is a huge problem. I think I overcommitted to like 11, 12. I overcommitted to the high numbers. Let's see if this pays off or not. I'm a little bit worried it's not going to pay off now. Oof. Come on, I want to see 11 and 12. I want to see 11 and 12. That is not 11 and 12. I can progress on 9 and 8, which I quite like. Let's see. What do we get? Yeah, not really what I want to see. That's 3 and 8, which is not too bad. Let's do 3 and 8. Let's try once further. Let's progress 9 a little bit further. Let's try one more. And let's get to 9. Let me push my luck a little bit further. Okay, I think let's end it here. It's not a great move up. I'm still trying to roll that 11 and 12. And I know the chances are very slim, but let's see. My opponent's about to close 5, which is really... Yeah, 5's closed. Oh, that's frustrating. That's really, really early. Oh, the progressions... What? They closed 5 and 7. Wow, they got lucky. And they're so close to 6 as well. Oh man, that was amazing that how lucky they got there. Yeah, that blue player just pushed 5 and 7 all the way. Wow, well played. Gee, can I race them? I wonder if I can race them for 6, because I need to close that 6 and shut it down for them. 9 and 6. I should have taken that 11 and 4, that was silly of me. 2 and 6. One more. 9. I'm going to stop it there. I should have taken that 11. That was a bit of a mistake on my side. I wasn't really paying attention to what I was doing. Oh no, you've got to be joking. How lucky is this person? I'm trying to race to close 6 from them. They've got a 6 here though. Ooh, this is going to be tight. 6 and 12, that's game. Oh my word, this blue player. Well played. So yeah, everyone, that is Can't Stop. As I said, really quick games, really fun games. I hope you enjoyed them. Not a game I apparently am very good at. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. Cheers. Enjoy.